Good evening, everybody. Good evening, everybody.
The network is poor. The network is poor. Please restart
network
your
is network. From which end?
Restart your network, please.
Okay. Can you hear me? My host. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, but the network is poor. Restart your system or your network.
Okay, let me change it. Hello, can you hear me, my host?
Yeah, it's better. It's better.
It's better now. Okay. Thank God. Let's start the class, my people. I believe everybody can hear me and you can see my strength. We are in this. Disposal. Let's take one more question on it. On disposal, then we'll move to cash flow, group cash flow. Thank God. Okay, let's start. SOPI is a public tech company acquired two subsidiaries. They've told me when they give you the question on that day, May 4, please endeavor to read everything because what has been disposed, they don't consolidate. The asset that has been disposed, we don't consolidate. According to to the standard. You will see write the name of it, consolidated financial statement. I showed you one yesterday, no problem. Now, he has two subsidiaries, Okotoyi and Bevoji, both public limited companies. The details of the acquisition as follows. Okay, the subsidiaries, Okotoyi, Bevoji. Date of acquisition, 1st November. Oh, he has given me the retaining at the date of acquisition. Share capital acquired. Fair value of the net asset. He has also given me the net asset. Okay, I can determine the group structure now to know the percentages acquired out of 200. How many? He acquired 200 out of how many? Don't forget, we are only talking about equity investment. I've sent everything to the platform now. Go the national note. This is on your platform, unless you want me to resend it again. It's on the platform.
Please go ahead, Prof. The time is on our side.
It's on the platform, please. Unless I've sent it earlier than this, unless you want me to repeat it again, to resend it again.
Prof, you need to go ahead to save time so that I can cover.
I have resend it. You can get that again. Because we don't have time, so we need to kickstart. Okay, the fair value of the net asset as acquisition, 400, 800. How many shares does he acquire? I will ask the question. Okay, he acquired 200. Out of how many shares? Out of how many shares? If you look at it, share capital out of 250 with a nominal value of 1 naira. 250 divided by 1 will give me 250. 200 over 250, that will give me the percentage. I think that is 80%. I will also do the same thing to know the numbers of share acquired in Bevoji, which is 300. 300. Out of how many? 500 share capital in Bevoji. 500. So 300 divided by 500, that will give me 60%. The two of them are subsidiary. I will go to that before I open everything. I will endeavor to read through the question. I will read through the question. There have been no issued shares of capital since November 2003, and the verbal adjustments have not been included in the subsidiary financial records. Okay, no issue. But if you see tracing for that, don't let us bother you so many things because you are still coming there. Look at it here. On 31st October 2005, after accounting for the result of the impairment test, SOPI sold 100 million shares in Bevoji for 180 million. He sold 100 million shares for Bevoji for 180 million. Because he lost control. This is the cash proceeds he collected. So we see maintain significant influence over Bevoji. That means, oh, part disposal. He has sold from being a subsidiary to associate. Because which investment do we maintain significant influence? That is an associate. Even without me, even testing it, I know it's an associate. Oh, the fair value of the remaining investment was 200. It's giving me the fair value of other remaining investments, the residual value of other remaining investments, meaning he has lost control. He has lost control. Don't forget, anything that we have lost control, any subsidiary we have lost control, we don't consolidate. We only calculate gain or loss on disposal. So let us look at this financial statements. I will now open it. The financial statement, okay? Consolidated SOP, consolidated financial statement. As at consolidated statement of financial position, as at which year am I consolidating? 31st October 2005, PPE, SOP, plus Okoto, 390. I will not consolidate the body. He has lost control. When he lost control, all assets and liability must be de-recognized. Investment in subsidiary for me to calculate my goodwill. Add to maturity investment, 30. I'll put goodwill. Immediately after the goodwill, I will leave two line space. Go to inventory. Inventory 200 plus 185. Trade receivable 170 plus 80. Cash and cash equivalent 40 plus 30. Oh, he has no current asset held for sales, 15 million. 0 plus 15 is 0 plus 15. That is it. Okay, that is my total asset. I will go again. Equity and liability, share capital, retaining. He still has one subsidiary, NCI. Go to the non-current asset, 250 plus 60. Current liability is 60 plus 110. Total equities. What do I need to balance this account? I need analysis of the group structure. When does it dispose? At the end of the year. Because I say after accounting for the result of the impairment test, at the end of the year, it went for, it disposed. So it's entitled to the retaining for the whole year. No issue. No issue. What do I do? Okay, let's go ahead. So no problem for the whole issue. Okay. Analysis of the group structure, adjusted retained of subsidiary, determination of net assets. The first subsidiary, Okotoyi. Items, date of acquisition, date of consolidation. Determination of net assets of subsidiary, Gbebody. Items, date of acquisition, and date of disposal, because it's not a consolidation again. He has disposed, date of disposal, DOD. They lost control. Then I need the goodwill. One will be goodwill at, to consolidate goodwill at DOD. I need retaining of the parents and NCI value at DOD. Let me share the solution to you so that you can see what I'm saying in totality. Yes, this is what I'm saying. I will now open it down. 70 plus that, I don't know what to add already. 70 plus 700 plus 390, I will add that. I don't know this one. I'll open everything and open it wide. Analysis of the group structure. Yes, the date of acquisition. Retaining and the date of acquisition, effective interest, NCI, and cost of investment. Adjusted retain any of subsidiary as per SOP. Don't forget 280, 290. Okay. Determination of net asset of subsidiary. Okotoyi. I'll open it down. Determination of net assets of subsidiary. DOADOD. DOADOD, not DOC. DOADOD. Then goodwill in Okotoyi and Gbebody. The goodwill of Gbebody, date of disposal. Then retain any of the parents. After retain any of the parents, I need to calculate NCI value at DOD and gain or loss on disposal. I need to calculate the gain or loss on disposal. The gain or loss on disposal. I need to calculate it. So, gain or loss on disposal of subsidiary. Okay. This is the first requirement. I can calculate gain or loss on disposal in two ways. This is the first requirement of the question. The question says, calculate gain or loss on disposal. The question says, calculate gain or loss on disposal on subsidiary that it disposed open to you. But there is no way I can calculate. Let's take it here. Let's leave it here. Let's go to the additional information that talks about it so that we can see. Does it lose control? I'll take my calculator to check in exam. Okay. So on 31st October 2005, at reporting date, after accounting for the result of impairment sales, Sopi sold 100 million shares in Baybody for 180. He sold 100 million. Out of how many does he have? He sold 100. Does he lose control? He has 60% initially, and he has sold 100. I would say, what is the percentage of the 100 he sold? He sold 100 million shares. Although with the information given in that, I know he has, I just want to confirm to you, okay, shares sold 100. The percentage of the shares sold, 100 over 500 times of the total, which is 500, it will give me 20%. Percentage of the shares acquired by the parent, 60. Minus the one is sold, 20%, making 40%. So 40% is what? Associates. Then, or alternatively, total numbers of shares acquired, 300. Shares sold, 100. Share remain, 200. 200 over total numbers of shares, 500 times 100, 40%. Investment in associates. With this one, I've established in the question, there's a disclosure. I will now start be reading the question and I'll be posting it. That's all. I'll give you a minute to react to this. In a minute, to react to this, please. In 1 minute. This is 9:26. In 9:27, if you don't react, then we are going to wait. Please react to it. My voice is breaking. I don't think so. How do I get the 500? I say, ask any question on this. Ask any question. You say, how do we get the 500? That is the total numbers of shares. Let's go to the question now. In exam, I say you must establish that there is disposal in the question. Look at it. How many shares does he have? How many shares does he acquire initially? How many shares does he sell? Share capital, 500. Which person are we talking about? We are talking about Baybody. He has sold the shares of Baybody. How many shares does he have in Baybody initially? He asks how many share capital acquire Baybody. This is Baybody, 300. How do I determine the group structure? 300 over 500, 60%. He has sold 100, 300 minus 100. I hope it's clear now what I'm trying to establish. This one has been sold. Baybody, they have lost control on it. Part disposal. To become an associate. Part disposal. Okay. Now go to the question one after the other. Let's go to the question and start post. Say there have been no issue. Don't forget, he has given me retainer at the date of acquisition. I've known the group structure. What is the retainer at this option 150? And the share capital he acquired 200. The fair value of the net asset, 400. The net asset, 400. Okay. From that, I can pose the solution. He has said, no problem. He has said, retaining, I can feel it. Because of investment, it has been given already. The share capital acquired to determine the group structure has also been given. Okay. This is it. Date of acquisition, 1/11/03. Retail any deduction, effective interest based on the share acquired, 200/250, 80%. NCI, 20. Cost of investment, 380. The same thing here, 210. He acquired 60%. NCI, 40. Cost of investment, 340. That's what I will know, 340, because it has been recorded. Go to your non-current assets. You will see the cost of investment in the non-current assets. Investment in subsidiary, O.238, Baybody, 340, recorded. Net asset, 400. I will suppose there have been no new issue shares in the group since 1st November 2003, and the fair value adjustments have not been included in subsidiary financial record. Okay. Said any increase in the fair value of the net asset over the carrying value at acquisition is attributed to plant and equipment. Plant and equipment is depreciated at 20% per annum on producing balance basis. What is the share capital? 250 in Okwotoyi. And he said the net asset is 400. Net asset, 400. What is the retail earning? 150. No problem. That means there's no changes. It's equal to the net asset. Net assets, share capital, 250. Retail earning, 150. 400, as given in the question. Rather than having a separate table for adjustments for subsidiary, can we include the net assets arrive at the same solution? I don't understand the question. Can we consolidate if the DOD is beyond we are required to consolidate? Can we consolidate if the DOD is beyond the year we are required to consolidate? These two questions need further explanation. It is not too clear to me. Okay, let's get to a reasonable length because I want us to search group cash flow. I will attend to the question, please. Let's calm down. You can be sending the question now. But let me. So the termination of the net asset subsidiary, the share is 250. The retail earning is 150, nothing changes. He said the fair value of the net asset is 400. Then let's move to the next one, the next subsidiary. He said the net asset is 800. What is the share capital? 500. Retail earning given 210, make it 710. And the net asset is 800. Something has happened. Which the question has told us. Look at this. The question has told us the net asset is 800, and it has given me the retail earning of 210. Don't forget Netta set at 5. Share capital, share premium, retain other components of equal, other components of equity, revaluation surplus. They are 5. No question can carry the 5. Net asset 800. Retail any 210. There's no share premium. You only have shares and retail any. I go to the shares. The share is 500 plus the 210, making 710. And he said the net asset must be 800. What happened? I'll go to the additional information too. He said any increase in the fair value of the net asset over the carrying value at acquisition is attributed to plant and equipment. And plant and equipment is divided 20% on reducing balance basis. Class, based on this, is it evaluation surplus or deficit? Then if you get the answer, what is the posting? Please tell me. Is it evaluation surplus or deficit? And if you get it, what is the posting? Shout me the answer. The question says, any increase in the fair value. Don't forget, he has given us the net asset. I want you to get this question and see the common pitfall students used to make. He has given us the net asset, 800. And he said on that, the retain is 210. And the share capital is 500. 500 plus 210, 710, and the net asset is 800. The net asset is 800. 710 does not equal to 800. I'm not asking class, is it evaluation? What happened? Is it evaluation surplus or deficit? And what is the post? Somebody asked me. Evaluation surplus of 90. Okay, I want to ask you, good. That is gotten. What is the posting? The accounting entry to post. You have gotten it. Evaluation surplus, 90. One leg, debit the PPE. You charge the position to the revaluation surplus. After we have debit the PPE, debit the PPE, credit the reserve of subsidiary. Good. Retain and PPE. Okay. As I've seen so many answers here. Why some are correct, why some have idea of what to do. Now, listen to me, please. If we are consolidating, the normal thing is somebody got, I think this one is correct, reserve of the subsidiary. I will debit the PPE and credit reserve. If I'm consolidating the subsidiary, this is the mistake, the pitfall they used to do in disposal. Anything that we have disposed, we don't consolidate. The revelation surplus cannot be added. We have disposed that subsidiary. This is the problem of disposal. So many people used to treat as if they are consolidating. Normally, if you are consolidating, I'm surprised with this some entry here, but this one is right. You are with debit the PPE and credit the reserve for the surplus. Provided I'm consolidating. But what we have disposed, we don't consolidate. We don't add the surplus to it. It's going away with the surplus. This is what you need to be put in your memory when you see disposal question. Therefore, WDPP will not arise at all because we have disposed it. It will only have one leg by crediting the reserve. Let me show you the solution. Please, you need to, that part, you need to let it stick to your memory that anything that we have disposed, we don't consolidate. Look at it. You cannot see the 90 in my PPE because I cannot debit PPE here. You cannot see the 90 here. Adibi, I have not disposed it, I will consolidate. It's going away with the surplus. I can only adjust it in the retail earning, adjusted retail earning of the disposer. Look at it here, the 90. Revaluation surplus of plant. One leg it will come. The other leg will be in its own account that is taken away. My own is just to determine what will be the net asset at DOD. I don't know what I'm saying, what I'm communicating. If you have disposed, it cannot come because it's going away with the surplus. Please take this fact correct. That is the mistake, and it will not let it balance. That is the mistake people used to make when it is comes to disposal. I used to warn them, look at the one that is disposed. Don't bring the anything that they have disposed into your consolidation. You will still call it the consolidated account, but you will not bring any of it item into the account again. It's going away with it. Okay, that is taking 90. Depreciation on it. Yes, I need to charge depreciation. And the question says, depreciation is charged 20% on reducing balance basis. Let me show you how depreciation is charged. On the depreciation. The revaluation surplus, the 90. Depreciation on reducing balance basis. Depreciation for year one, 0.2 times 90, 18. Carrying amount, reducing balance. Depreciation for year two, 0.72, 14.4. The total depreciation charge on the surplus, 18 plus year one, 18, plus year two, 14.4, giving me a total of 32.4 now. I will not go and adjust it. No second leg in its retail earning. I will not go to the retail earning of the subsidiary disposed and adjust it there. Adjusted retail earning, depreciation 32.4. No second leg. It has been disposed. It's going to be in its own book. The, its own asset surplus. where he's taking his own value go, his people can go and do that. Before we proceed, 2 minutes to ask question, please. 2 minutes to ask question. Are we debiting disposal account and credit reserve? No. Disposal account that you are talking about that we have in our own book, what is our own duty when they dispose is to calculate gain or loss on disposal. Anything we have disposed, no. We don't have this asset in our book. It's the sales proceeds I will credit to my disposal account is the sales proceeds with cash, not the asset, not the depreciation. I don't have that in my book. What I will only have is the money collected from selling the subsidiary, and I will debit my bank to increase, like yesterday one, and credit my sales proceeds account. No reserve for it, too. Let him go and treat it in his own book, his subsidiary. Let me give you a practical example. If you divorce your wife, God forbid, and you have access to the account of your wife before disposing, after disposing, your wife will have gone to, is that how you collect the ATM card from you? Or go to our bank and block you from having access to that account. All the property that your wife bought into the house, including the one you bought for her when this relationship is going smoothly, after the disposal, she's going to go away with everything. But nowadays, I am surprised seeing the man collecting what he has bought for the wife to be. I don't know whether you see that comedy that went around, that went viral online. The man removed the sneakers, removed the rice, take the rice on top of the table because they are a disposer. We don't have access to what has been disclosed. This is the pitiful, common pitiful student need to make a disposal. Please. We are still coming there now, madam. Any suru, egbe suru je. We are coming there. You will get it. Okay. Let's go back to the question. That part is clear. I'll go to the additional information next as I'm reading and posting. Ogboto is sold plant to equipment to Sopi on 12 November 2005. On 12 November, when am I consolidating? Is it not 31st October? It's ruling brain. What happened? Is it part of my accounting year? Or is it an adjusting event? What happened? Because I'm consolidating that event. If you now sold to him on November 12th. Okay. What happened? I will read further. The transaction was completed at an agreed price of 15 million after selling costs. The transaction complied with the condition of IFRS 5. Oh, IFRS 5, no current asset. Held for sales. Before we can classify an asset held for sales, it must be within the 1 year. That means at the beginning of the year, management must identify this as held for sales because they say they meet the whole criteria that complies with the condition. One of the conditions is management must locate buyer and there must be active plan. So, and it must be available in a sellable condition, all the conditions of IFRS 5. Because before you can sell the asset at the end of the year, you must have classified it separately and identified. start looking for buyer. With, and it must be sold within that 12 months. That is what the standard says. Okay. Current assets held for sales and discontinued operation for disclosure as an asset. Held for sales. The plan and the equipment has been valued at fair value less cost to sales in the individual account of Hope Portoy. As at 1st November 2004, beginning of the year, can you see? This plan and equipment had a carrying value of 10 million and no depreciation on these assets has been charged for the year ended as well as October 2004. Why depreciation is not charged? Because it must be abandoned in immediate chargeable, sellable condition. In line with the IFRS, so I have no depreciation. But who is he selling the asset to? He's selling to the parent, Okotoyi. That is wrong. And he has sell it and make profit again because he said the carrying amount is 10 million. As at the beginning of the day, when they identified as F for sales, even though this transaction complied with IFRS 5, it has go contrary to another standard. IFRS 3, you cannot sell to each other because we are a single entity. Therefore, this asset cannot be classified as held for sales. He has opened held for sales account. If you look at this, say put it as part of the PPE, no current asset classified as held for sales, 15 million. That's, this asset cannot be classified as held for sales. Why? Because you are selling it to your parents at agreed price on SOPI on 12 with 15 million. What do? I will not credit S for sales account, remove it from S for sales, add it back to the PPE, first and foremost. Don't classify as S for sales, put it back as a part of the PPE. Look at it. Credit S for sales accounts that are classified, remove it from emphasis, then by crediting, then debit PP plus 15. Has it made profit on the sales? Yes, because the asset carry amount is 10. It sold it 15. And it has accounted for, according to the question, for by both parties. What do I do? It must be eliminated. There is only unrealized profit on it. Who is the seller? Subsidiary. He sell to the parent and make profits. Profit of how much? 5. I do as okay, credit the PPE to bring it down to 10. And debit retain any. I will not debit the retain any. Help for sales account. Debit 5. Air for sales. The unrealized profit on air for sales 5. Unrealized profit on air for sales 5. Am I going to charge depreciation? Yes. It is no longer air for sales again. Therefore, I need to charge depreciation on it. And they say it's the policy of the organization to charge 20% depreciation. Let's go there to see for the depreciation. Plan and equipment is divided on a straight line basis, then on 20% per annum on reducing balance. So on that 10, I need to charge the depreciation 20%. 20% of 10, 2. I will credit the PPE. That is why you see we credit the PPE. So let me take the solution and show you the place we did all that. I will credit the PPE, depreciation 2, Okotoyi accounts. And it does not charge because it classifies as S for sales. I will not take it credit the PPE minus two for the depreciation. Let me take it to where the solution as regarding that is done. The solution as regarding that. F for sales, agree price, not F for sale because it was sold for the parent now. PPE, I will debit 15. Credit L for sales, 15. Profit on L for sales, selling price, carry amount, 5. Depreciation, 2. That is everything about it. Please ask questions as regarding this. Let's see. Ask question. Why are we not eliminating the sales? My brother, don't miss this thing up. Sales, inventory, they sell to each other. Inventory, intergroup sales, revenue, if it is inventory, they sell to each other. Why are we not eliminating the sales? Inventory, they don't profit. They are not into selling of assets, and there is no POL here. They are not into selling of assets, and there is no POL here. When they sell to each other inventory, what the company is dealing with, it must be eliminated in the revenue and in the cost of sales. Why don't the 10 be classified as S for sales and depreciate reflecting the net asset? No, because they agree 15 million, it classifies as S for sales 15 million because the parent and the subsidiaries agree 15 million. The parent does not know that the carry amount in his book is 10. He made profit of 5 on it. But further information and further investigation reveal to us, the question reveals to us that the carry amount is 10, no, not 15. I didn't mean the carry amount is 15. I will not have charged unrealized profit on plants, on F for sales. I will not have charged unrealized profit on for sales account. But the question says the carry amount is 10, but he agreed to collect 15 million from the parents. So what do I do? The 15 million, I need to take it back to the net asset. And I realize that, oh, this asset is 10, not 15. I will eliminate the profits now to bring it down to what? Carrying amount by crediting the FPPE with 5 to bring it down to 10. The profit you declare is overstated by the gain on the F for sales. I will remove it 5 on it. That is it. And it classifies as S for sales. No depreciation will be charged. Now it is no longer F for sales. Depreciation of 20% because they say it's the policy. Don't forget, one of the way to consolidate the effective interest, there must be uniform accounting policy. There must be uniform accounting policy. They have showed me that accounting, reducing balance basis, is how they depreciation on 20%. So 20% of 10 will give me 2. What do I do to the 2? I'll credit PPE and I will debit with any of the owner of the asset, which is open to it. Which is open to it. Hope that is clear. Now, let's move to the next one. Let's move to the next one. So B has purchased a debt instrument. A debt instrument with 5 years remaining to maturity on 1st November 2003. The purchase price and the fair value was 30 million on that day. Okay, what comes to your mind when I say we purchase a debt instrument? Let me ask you, class. What comes to your mind when you see a death instrument, purchase a death instrument, what really comes to your mind? What are you figuring? You are in exam. You see death instrument, purchase a death instrument. What will come to your mind? Because you are going to write the exam very soon, May 4. Let's assume you are in exam hall. Somebody has chopped. Yes. Oh, deeper consideration. Deeper consideration. Deeper consideration. Deeper consideration. When do we use deeper consideration? Somebody is giving us a clear loan. Death instrument is a deeper consideration. No, deeper consideration can only be applied when we purchase a subsidiary and we are paying in the future. Somebody said no current liability. Somebody said loan. Loan, debt instrument. No current liability. See a liability. Purchase. When we acquire a subsidiary and we are saying we are going to pay in a future date, it is an investment. Debt instrument, an investment. Okay. Loan. Debt instrument, loan. Okay. Now, in exam, if I'm doing an exam and I see debt instruments, what will come to my head? Financial instrument. Financial instrument. Debt instrument. What are the debt instruments? Bond. Treasury bill. Treasury certificate. Debenture. These are the debts. I'll now ask the question, is it a liability or asset? Don't forget your financial instrument. What do we mean by financial instrument? A transaction, a contract that gives rise to one party as an asset, the other party liability. For the asset, construction obligation to receive cash or other equity instruments of another entity in a favorable term. Asset, liability to deliver or give its own equity instrument to another entity in unfavorable condition. Those who are saying low, they are not far fetched from the truth. Loan is a perfect example of a financial instrument. Financial instrument cannot be classified into two: financial asset, financial liability. How do I know it's an asset? How do I know it's a liability in exam? If I'm buying a shares, I'm buying shares from GTB, I'm giving GTB money, they will give me certificate of order. What am I buying? Asset, financial asset. They have obligation to deliver cash to me in form of dividend, they will pay me dividend. And only other thing that I'm interested in that the company is giving, because I'm part of their shareholder, by purchasing shares, I'm buying an asset, not a liability. If I'm giving you loan, you are issued your company, they are in financial difficulties, they approach you, you now give them loan of 100. You are the one, you purchase a debt instrument. They are going to give you, maybe in form of bond, they issue bond. The company is the one that issue. You are the one that buy the bond. You are giving them money. When you are giving them money, they will give you certificate of indebtedness to you that they are owing you for the money you are parting away with. you will collect your principal and interest. You are buying what? Assets. If you buy Treasury B from government, if government issue a Treasury certificate and you purchase a Treasury certificate from government, what are you buying? You have given government money. You are buying an asset. Government is owing you. They are to pay your principal. And based on the condition, the contract, you sign with them on the condition for the Treasury certificate, the interest on it, they will give you money on it, interest. So they will pay you back the principal and the interest. So anytime you see in any question, purchase, you are buying an asset. But if you see sell, issue, you are buying a liability, financial liability. I don't know whether the two is clear to you. Whether it is clear to you. SOPI buy debt instruments. SOPI give them money. They will give. And it will be paid back in 5 years' time, remaining to maturity on 1st November. Let's go further. Financial instrument says financial asset and financial liability. You have an asset. Asset can be classified into two. Financial asset can be classified into two. Equity, you are buying shares. If you see they buy shares, like what we are doing, group is buying shares. But this one is beyond, it's a subsidiary. What do we mean by it's beyond? Shares in financial instruments range from 1% to 19%. It does not give control. If you buy shares, so instead of control, you have changed investment from financial instrument to subsidiary, from a simple investment to subsidiary. Subsidiary means, simple investment means from 1% to 19%. If you are purchasing a shares from GTB, you are parting away with your money, they will give you, you are buying equity. So financial asset can be classified into two, equity. How do we account for equity? Equity can be accounted using fair value through profit or loss, fair value through other comprehensive income. Debt now. Don't forget, we say financial asset can be classified into two, equity and debt. Debt can also be, you can buy debt from any company. Like you are purchasing a bond, debenture, you are buying debt. The debt cannot be classified, cannot be accounted for in three ways. At amortized cost. One, fair value through profit or loss. And fair value to other comprehensive income. That is the three ways we can value debt, financial assets. Financial assets can be equity, can be debt, two of them, equity and debt. When we are talking about shares, equity. When we are talking about debt, you are talking about debt, equity, debt, loan, debt. So, and if you are holding it to maturity, it must be amortized. Please, you can read your financial instruments. I have a table, a diagram to that, which I will send for clarity, will assist you in your reading. I will send it to the platform. Maybe it can assist you in your reading. Okay? So he has bought the debt and is going to hold it to maturity. Then it needs to be amortized in line with IFRS 9. Debt, okay, he bought debt, 30 million. If you go to the financial statement, where does he recorded it? And as he told you, head to maturity, meaning look at it, it's an asset to him. Head to maturity, financial asset. And even his liability, if it's one issue debt instrument, you will see it in no current liability under here. 30 million will have been here. Okay. So it must be amortized. How do we amortize? Don't forget the amortization table. opening value, effective interest rates, the fixed interest, and the closing value. Okay. Under the instrument will be paid back in 5 years' time at an amount of 37.5. That means it's holding it to maturity. It's going to collect interest and the principal. Solely for the collection of interest and the principal. That is the business motive, the objective, and the characteristics of the cash flow is to collect interest and the principal. It must be amortized. It must be amortized. Excuse me. It must be amortized over the 5 years period. But when does he buy it? 1st November. Don't forget, we are consolidating 31st of October 2005, 2 years. So he has told me that instrument carry a fixed interest rate of 4.7% per annum on the principal. He has conditioned me. The agreement that is 4.7% on the principal. If you have not said this, I'll play the 4.7% on the tax and ask effective interest rate of 10%. The fixed interest has been received and accounted for, but no accounting entry has been made other than the recognition of the original purchase price of the instrument. Good. So I will now amortize it. Let me show you the solution. It must be amortized. Yeah, one, the day you bought this thing, we bought it in November, 1st November 2003, and the first interest we accrued to us, 30 million. Effective interest rate, 10% on the 30, which will give me 3. Then the fixed interest rate is 0.047 times the principal amount of that 7, 1.76. I will now say 30 plus 3, I'm amortizing, minus the fixed interest to give me 31.24, which is going to be the opening value, the closing value here will be the opening value in the next year, which we are preparing the account. That 1.24 at the beginning of the year, we are consolidating. 10% will give us 3.31. It is fixed throughout 1.76. I will now say 3124 minus plus 31. That's 1.24 plus 3124 minus 1.76 will give me 32.6. This is the closing value of my financial asset at year two when I'm consolidating. If I'm continuing to do it down, I will get 37.5. I will get 37.5. So 32.6. And the question says he has not accounted for it. He only accounted for the principal. The principal is 30 million. 30 million. The principal of 30 million. I will ask, okay. The gain of 2 million now. See, look at it. Add to maturity financial assets. I will debit the interest of 2.60. Retain of the parent, 2.6. So if you go up, look at it. We shall posted retain any of the parents. We have credited this account. Gain on earth to maturity. The interest on it, 2.6. Then debit the financial asset, which is 30 million plus 2 million. 30 plus 2 million, giving me 32.6. Any question before we proceed to the next one? Any question before we proceed? Any question before we proceed? Any question before we proceed? Any question before we proceed to the next one? Okay. In the absence of no question, let me go to the next adjustment. goodwill arising on acquisition of a subsidiary was impairment tested on 31st October 2004 and 2005 because impairment is done annually in accordance with IAS 36 impairment of an asset. There was no impairment of goodwill on the acquisition of Okotoyi or Baybush. No impairment. Then says, on 31st October, after accounting for the result of impairment set, Sopi sold 100 million shares in Baybody for 180 million. Sopi still maintains significant influence over Baybody. After disposal of the shares, the fair value of the remaining investment, don't forget the investment is not an associate. What is the fair value of the remaining investment? I will debit investment, credit my sales proceed account for the calculation of gain or loss on disposal at that date. The receipts, somebody who is asking me, why do you debit the 180? Why do you add the 180 to the cost of investment? See, he said the receipts. The receipts or the sales proceed has been recorded in the cash book. They've recorded, they've debited the cash book. And as a reduction in the carrying value on the cost of investment in subsidiary, my brother, this is the language of disposal. And any question on disposal, this is how they used to structure it. Don't fall maggot or I can. Please, this is how they structure it. First and foremost, the one we did yesterday, they've not posted. They've not posted the accounting entry. We debit the cash and credit sales proceed. This person has debited the cash already. Where is the second leg? Instead of credit, he says proceed account for the calculation of goodwill. He said reduction. And as a reduction in the carrying value of the cost of investment in subsidiary. Which subsidiary? Ogbebody. He has reduced the cost of investment. He has credited. He debits cash book and credit. I will now correct the entry. This is the language you are expecting in our disposal. I will send another question for practice. You will still see the same language inside it. That is their language. They will debit the cash book and credit. They will not credit. That is how they used to do. You are the one to reverse the entry. How do you reverse the entry? You will not say no problem. What are you going to do? You go to the cost of investment. You have credited that place by reducing. I will add it back again. Debit and credit says proceed account. That's what we are seeing. That's what we are seeing. Please watch out for this language. Watch out. The money they collected is either they have not posted, they have not made the entry to that, which I will debit the cost of investment. I will debit the cash to increase the cash. After debiting the cash, I'll credit the sales proceeds. But they will set two, second one, they will have said they have debited the cash book. They will not credit the reduction cost of investment in the subsidiary disposal. I will not reverse the entry by debiting the cost of investment hard to it and credit sales proceed account. That is it. That is what I have done in the question. It is the group policy to value non-controlling interest as it proportionally shares of the fair value of the subsidiary identifiable net as. So it is sure proportionate. It is sure proportionate, but the first requirement A, calculate gain or loss will be recorded in the group financial statement. There's no way I can calculate gain or loss, my brothers and sisters. If I don't open the necessary account, I'm not spiritual. I cannot see ahead. I will just open the account up, write the formula, then go to B part. After the B part, I copy and paste to the A part. That is it. It's a time consuming. Anybody that starts with the A cannot finish the question. He cannot finish the question. I cannot see that person finish. I cannot see that person is a matter. he cannot finish. You must start from B, but leave page A for A. After you have finished your B, you take it, the gain or loss on disposal to A. Okay? That is it. We are saying, I hope my sister that is asking me, how do I add the 180 back to the cost of investment? It is clear to you now. If it is not clear, I can still recap. I can still record what I've said. I can see. But, okay, now, let's go back to the solution so that I can show you what I've said. Any question for me? Any question for me? Any question for me? So, he has debited the cash. Where is my cash? I don't need to debit again. I don't need. The parent has what your stats. So, the cost of investment will be debited by 180 and credit says, this will give me 273. Why this one give me 257? I'll bring the 273 down. 273 minus 150 to give me 123. What happened to the 123? I will share the post, share of profit. Then this one, I'll bring the 2576 from the adjusted retained 2576. After taking the depreciation, I want to calculate the net asset at DOG. 2576.6. 2576 minus 210 will give me 47.6. The 47.6 now, how do I go about treating it? Share of post. Can I calculate the goodwill? Yes. The cost of investment, 380. We bought it, 520. After adding the 180 back, add NCR. The net asset in 800 is 40%. 40% of 800 will give me 320. 520 minus 320 will give me 840. Then I will less 800 to give me 40. This is the goodwill at DOD because there was no impairment. Then I will go to the other one too. What is the net asset at the date of acquisition? 400. 20% of 400, that will give me 80. 380 plus 80 will give me 460. Net asset at DOE to give me 60. I'm consolidating Okwotoyi goodwill. I will write it immediately. 60. I'll put my gain or loss on disposal. I'll put 60 there. In my gain or loss on disposal. Okay, goodwill. 60. Then 40 for the disposal. 40. Gain or loss on disposal. The goodwill at DOD. I'll put my 40 here. Then retain emphasis. Share of profit is collecting 80% of 123, which will give me 98.4. But Baybody is collecting 60%. Is collecting 60% of 47.6. 60% of that will give me what? 28.56. The remaining gain or loss on disposal. I've got in my net asset at DOD, 847.6. That is the net asset at DOD. NCR value at DOD for everybody, date of consolidation. Okay, DOA 80, share of profit is collected 20% of 123, which will give me 24.6. Then this share profit 19.04. Okay, we have said there is no goodwill attributed to NCR. The same way I've gotten date of acquisition, the same way I'm getting date of consolidation. Just multiply what is the net asset at DOC. The net asset at DOC, check it, which is for everybody 827.6 DOD for 523. I will just multiply because there is no goodwill attributed to NCR. You need to know this thing very well this particular one, when it is so proportionate, and she are only entitled to net asset, no good be, unless for impairment testing purposes, unless for impairment testing purposes, where recoverable amount is given. That is it. In this case, there is no recoverable amount given. I will just multiply the percentage on NCI on it, which will give me this. The same answer as this. Same thing to give me this. So I'm consolidating Opotoi. I'll take his NCI there. Then how to calculate my gain or loss on this loser. Let me calculate my gain or loss on this loser. And I say, no problem. Sales proceed, 180. Fair value of the remaining investment, 400. So give me 580. Total consideration, 580. Net asset disposed. Sorry for that. The battery is running low. Net asset disposed. The goodwill is gone. The goodwill. But net asset at DOD, 84.7.6. NCI value at DOD, 33.04. If I subtract it, it will give from 580, it will give me gain of 31.4. This is one involving NCI. Don't forget, nobody will ask you. Involving NCR, not involving NCR. This is just an illustration to show you the difference between the two. Don't go to the exam and go and write gain or loss on disposal involving NCR. No, you'll just say gain or loss on disposal or subsidiary. Here is what to get the clarity of the difference between the two. I don't want to involve NCR. Sales proceed, 180. Fair value of the remaining investment, 400, 580. Total consideration, 580. Net asset disclosed. The goodwill belongs to the parent only. Goodwill at DOD. Net asset at DOD of the parent only is 0.6 times 8.6, which will give me this, plus the goodwill, which will give me 580.56. You see, give me the gain. What am I going to do to the gain? I'll credit retain. I will credit the retained. I'll send the solution. I'll send the question and the solution. Don't know why somebody is asking me. It's on the platform. And I believe everybody is on the platform. I believe unless you are an external paper person, I trust my chairman who will have done it by adding you to this platform. Okay? I've resent again. I will credit retained. Gain, the gain of 31.4, I will not credit retain any of the parents. I will credit retain any of the parents for it. The consolidated retain any, I will not credit it. If it is lost, I will also do that. After summing everything, you give me 101,1011. That is the consolidated retain. Then I can now consolidate. No story. I can now consolidate. The share capital of the parent on the retain 101. Then it's here. No current liability, current liability. Then the PP 1098. 2.6, 60 for the goodwill. Investment in associate that remain. Fair value of the remaining investment, 385, trade receivable, and cash. That is the end of the question. That is the end of the question. On that note, on that note, Let's ask questions. On that note, let's ask questions. Or download. Yes, ask question. No question. There's one already. It was adjusted. Is there any? Depreciation. So on unrealized depreciation on the held for sales. Unrealized profit held for sales. It made profit of 5, which utters a problem, and the depreciation as I surprised the 7 to give me 273. That's why I get it 273. Any other question? What is the difference between the simple cash flow and group cash flow? Cash flow. Cash can only flow in two ways. We have said that. We have done the group cash flow. Let's go to what? Let's go to the group cash flow. We have done the simple cash flow. Let's take time to do the group cash flow. Yes, why do we do disposal before the cash flow? There can also be disposal before the group cash flow. They can also dispose before the group cash flow. Okay. Now, please take notes. We are praying this diet. I've been praying personally that cash flow should be the number one question for this diet. The reason be that cash flow is very, very simple. Without even you doing anything, you will get the answer correctly. Now, please. Write these differences down. Difference between simple cash flow and group cash flow. The difference between simple cash flow you have done in FR that we have just did one question on it. Difference between simple cash flow and group cash flow. First, the title, the heading. The heading will change from statement of cash flow to consolidated statement of cash flow. That is one. Two, there will be acquisition. There may likely be acquisition and disposal of subsidiary. Two, there may likely be acquisition and disposal, or both. It could be both. There will likely be acquisition and disposal, or both. Two of them. Some question like this question carry both the acquisition and disposal. That is two. Three, calculation of goodwill and test for impairment. You calculate goodwill and test for impairment. Four, calculate the goodwill and test for impairment. Four, consolidate the net asset acquired and let the net asset dispose. We consolidate the net asset acquired and let the one dispose. That is four. You consolidate the net asset acquired and let the one dispose. Five. Investment in associates. Drop investment in associates. Investment in associates in the question. Six. Dividend paid to parent and NCR. The dividend paid to parent and NCR. Dividend paid to parents and NCR would be in the question. And the last one, the application of accounting standard, which is the most difficult part of the question, the application of the accounting standard. I will not send to you 10 questions on group cash flow with their respective solutions. On which thing group, which I think is the most difficult question ACCA have ever tested. I have solved it and I've done the audio solution to each one of how the answer is being arrived. You only need to listen to the audio, have the solution in your hand. Start taking it the way I get it. Then you cannot practice on your own. But every other one has been given. I don't know where FCA management extended our last revision class, which is going to hold on 30th of April. Physically, in our location, in Lagos here, it's precisely. I don't know whether they extend it to this student on this platform, online. If, for adventure, they extend it, I'll verify from the chairman, then get back if they extend it. If you are in Lagos, you can join us. If, don't quote me wrong, I'm not too sure about that. I don't know whether it's the chairman that is my host this night, which he can put information, etc. Yeah. If you do that, then on April 30, you can join us. He wants to concentrate on 5 things on that day. That is one, cash flow, disposal, piecemeal, sub and D-shape, and foreign subsidiary. Those are the 5 areas we are going to deal with. It will start from 9 a.m. and end 6 p.m. because of those who want to fast, can go and break their fast. That is the reason the management has decided. This is not the first time. It's free. So far, you are a student register. But I don't sure whether it is extended to the online platform. Provided if you are in Lagos, anyway. If you are in Kano, like Kamino, you cannot from Kano or in Abuja, you come into Lagos because of that. That will not be wise enough. Okay. Now, let's read Kusawekwe. Let's see how far we can take before our time is over. Let's see. Kusawekwe. Okay. Let's go to the requirement. So prepare a consolidated statement of cash flow for the Kusewe Group for the year ended 30 September 2012. Okay. So the heading, consolidated. That's okay. They had a consolidated statement of cash flow. Then, normal way, don't forget the template. The template will guide us. What is the profit before tax? Operating activities. I've written the heading. We'll see we consolidate statement of profit or loss. But yeah, I'll pick. What is the profit before tax? Which is 1115. Or add back non-cash item. Don't forget, what are the non-cash items? Depreciation, amortization, goodwill, other impaired or written off. Look at the goodwill at the beginning, 1812. At the end, it's 1930. PPE, investment in associates. It has increased, has not impaired. Don't forget, I said the difference between the day acquire subsidiary, the day dispose. Okay? I will go. If they acquire subsidiary, I will see that in the notes, they dispose subsidiary. Depreciation charge of 3 days was charged during the year. Add back my cash item. I'm going to add depreciation. Plant with a carry amount of 250 was sold for 275. Information on disposal. Whatever it is profit, I will less. If it is loss, I will add. Okay. Certain property will revalue. If I'm calculating my PPE. During the year, Kosovo acquired 80%, they acquire during the year. Share capital of them, paying cash consideration of 1.5 million. NCI was measured at fair value. NCI was measured at fair value, which is 3/4 at the date of acquisition. Oh, they've given me the net asset. The student is so convinced. Net asset of cash flow without of this group account. The group account, the net asset is equities. Share capital, share retaining, share premium, valuation surplus. But here they will list the net asset for you. PPE, the net asset you acquire, inventory, receivable, they will not submit all. So the last time they said, I can did not submit. Know that trade payable is a liability. They just list the item. You have to use your more common sense to look the one that is asset and liability and remove it, which is 1490. 1490. This is the net asset at the date of acquisition. He has given me the cost of investment, 15. I will add NCI, 340, then less the net asset at acquisition. They also dispose. Don't forget, before you dispose, there must be acquisition. Before we dispose, there must be acquisition. Let's go. During the year, Kosovo disposed of equity shareholding in stone for a cash proceed of 850. Oh, he has disposed it for 850. The subsidiary has been acquired. Don't forget, before we can dispose, there must be acquisition. Several years ago for a cash consideration of 600. Oh, cost of investment when he acquired an NCI holding was measured at fair value of 320 at acquisition. And the fair value of stone net assets were 730 at acquisition. So, goodwill had not suffered any impairment at the date of disposal. The net asset was sold. The net asset, they will list it for you. These are the dates for disposal. Now it, but as acquisition, 730. I will now calculate the goodwill to show whether it has been paid. Let me show you the solution. No. For the solution, I will now show you how it is being done. And so question is question. unfortunately, I've not opened the solution. Okay, no problem. Don't let us rush this one. Don't let us rush it. We have Monday. But today I will send all the cash flow to the group. Then on Monday, then we will solve some. Then Tuesday, we will go to piecemeal acquisition. Tuesday, we'll go to piecemeal acquisition. And I think that is how far we can go. But okay. Any question, please ask me a question before we call it a day. Ask me a question before we call it a day. Any question? Any question? Any question for me? Any question for me? In the absence of no question, and we can call it a day. Okay, somebody has asked question. Okay, thank you very much for your time. Please go through what we have done in case you have any issue. In case we have any issue, please don't hesitate to call my number or chat me on it private chat. We know we have so many things to deal with, but so many, we are feeling the pressure too. As you want to write the exam, we have you at our hearts. We are also feeling the pressure. In short, I feel the pressure now more than when I was a student writing the exam. We always think what would be the number one, what would be the standard. So in that sense of, we can call it a day. And Sherman.